At some point, when you're learning Spanish, you're going to need to type in Spanish. You know, to use your ñ and your upside down exclamation points and your letters with accents on them. And if you're on a Chromebook, there's an easy way so that you can switch from an English language keyboard to a Spanish language keyboard and go back and forth. On this machine, on the lower right hand side, see that little US? I can click on that, go over to keyboard, and switch back and forth. Today, I'm going to show you how to install that feature and then how to use it. So let's get going. Go down to the bottom right and click on the time. We are going to select the settings, that sprocket. We will scroll down, and there in the device section, we will select keyboard. We will scroll down a little bit more, and we want to select change input settings, add input method, and here we want to search. So I'm going to type in Spanish. I will be presented with two choices, Spain or Latin America. They're essentially the same. There's some small differences. I would recommend the Spain choice. Click add, and then we close. You're done. Now, you have the ability to switch between English and Spanish keyboards in any program that you're using where you would type. So how do we do it? The most important key is what I'm going to refer to as the magic key. If you're looking at your English keyboard, is where your apostrophe and quotes are. So to write an accent on a vowel, you're going to place your magic key once, and then your vowel. Magic key once, release, and your vowel. Hit the magic key, release, hit your vowel. If you need to have an accent on an uppercase vowel, hit your magic key and release, and now shift in your vowel. Magic key release, shift, and vowel, and you can keep going. The other thing that you might need are the two dots, or the diéresis, on top of a U. We're going to hold down shift, and while we're holding shift, hit your magic key. Now release, both shift and your magic key, and hit U. I'm going to do that one again. Hold down shift and hit your magic key, release both of them, and now hit U. The next most common thing that you're going to need are your question marks and your upside down exclamation point. So if we look at the top of your keyboard to the right of the zero, I can do shift and I will get my normal question mark. And then to the key right next to it, the plus equal sign, shift, and the upside down question mark. And that same key, if I don't use shift, I get the upside down exclamation point. There are two more that I want to point out that are pretty common. The first is the ñ. So the ñ is to the right of the L, what used to be the colon and semicolon, so ñ, or shift in that, and I will get the uppercase ñ. If we look down at where we see the comma, 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 shift in comma is now semicolon. We have the period. Shift in period is now the colon. Quote, shift, and the number 2. The other thing that you're going to see on that number 2 is how you get the at sign. You're actually going to use right, alt, and 2. I will leave a link to both of these pictures that I got from Wikimedia Commons so that if you wanted to print these out and see them. Now you know. Switch back and forth between English and Spanish. If you have any questions, let me know. Suerte.